All of the rice has been harvested in this mountain village. The rice fields in Kyoto, Ohara, are engulfed in the cool October air. The red spider lily has bloomed a bit late this year. The chestnuts are starting to color nicely. Ohara is showing signs of autumn. Venetia has started to take out her winter clothes in her 100-year-old house. From the flowers in her garden, we can tell the season is changing. The cosmos, planted at the end of summer, sway lightly in the wind. Venetia is working on her garden, taking care of the autumn flowers she adores so much.
この sage は可愛い。シソの花も綺麗。ロイもいいし。
She is enjoying all the different varieties of flowers while pruning. The garden has a relaxed beauty in autumn. Venetia wants to spend as much time in her garden as possible during this season. Venetia learned flower arrangement in England, and she continued her study in Japan for 10 years. Now she is using autumn flowers in her arrangement. The bristle grass looks like a kitten's tail.
ネコザラシ。ネコ、ネコザラシ。イングリッシュでは、bristle grass。ネコザラシの方が可愛い感じ。
The flower basket in the entrance greets the guests that come to Venetia's home. Venetia likes to combine Japanese flowers with flowers from other countries and create her own unique arrangement. She is grateful it is autumn and utters a word of thanks.
Tranquility was hanging in the autumn air. The sun was hot, and without my hat, my head needed to cool down. I sat down on the swing and sipped a cup of hot lemongrass tea. The slim spikes of the tropical lemongrass are growing tall at the entrance to our forest garden. The fresh stalks and leaves, swaying in the soft breeze, have a clear lemony smell and are well known as a deodorizer and insect repellent. If we have a week of warm, dry weather, this is the time to harvest the long stalks and dry them to use in a herb tea or to flavor a spicy curry. The grass is a tonic and helps digestion. It induces perspiration to cool the body and reduce a fever. So I find that lemongrass tea works wonders for a feverish cold. Feed a cold, starve a fever.
Venetia looks forward to the scent of her homemade lemongrass deodorant, which she'll make by hand. She tears up lemongrass and boils it in purified water. Add 1 cup of coriander and a eucalyptus branch, then boil it on low heat for 10 minutes. This is Venetia's original recipe, using herbs that have natural deodorizers. The cool scent of lemongrass fills the room. The finishing touch is essential oil. 20 drops of lemongrass and 5 drops of both eucalyptus and cedar wood. Ten drops of lavender oil for fragrance. Now all she has to do is mix it all together and it's done. She puts it in a glass spray bottle so she can take it anywhere.
Lemongrass to coriander and deodorant.
The fresh smell of lemongrass and the sweet smell of lavender complete this deodorant. It is something Venetia cannot be without. As the wind gets colder, Venetia looks forward to changing her summer stoles for warmer ones. Leaving England first for India and then to Japan, Venetia remembers memories along her path to where she is today.
これ全部思い出があるね。これイギリスの昔のやつで。
Her collection has everything from magnificent velvet stoles to traditional saris from India. Each one is important and has a special place in her memory. They represent the path she has taken up until now. Venetia enjoys taking walks. She must take care of her shoes, as they always accompany her.
It's quarter to three.
However, Venetia has larger feet than most Japanese women. Most of the time, only men's sizes fit her. She has trouble finding what she likes. Venetia wants to wear some formal, elegant shoes. She decides to go to a shoe store that caught her attention before. She heads south of Ohara, along the Kamo River. Nishijin in Kyoto has a rich 1400-year history in textiles and fabrics. She visits a shoe workshop run by shoe designer Kosuke Nojima. This is an order-made specialty shoe store. There are over 30 pairs of shoes designed by Nojima-san on the second floor. Geta, or Japanese wooden clogs made with leather, are quite rare. Nojima-san discusses everything with his customers, from materials and color patterns to the kinds of soles and laces.
これがデザイン帳なので見てみてください。綺麗なあのね、結婚式とか、そういう特別なパーティーの時靴持ってないから。そうすると、まあヒールはあまり
はい、こういうパンプスの類ですね。色はいろいろ。はい、色はここから選べるので、いろいろ選べます。
She goes with black and brown for her shoes. He has a specialized tool to measure shoe sizes. The first step in making comfortable shoes is the measurement. Even the slightest mistake can ruin everything. Nojima-san looks like he is concentrating very hard. While remembering her childhood, Venetia is very excited. There is still a lot of work left to do. They discuss the finite details, like the design and the thickness of the strap. Venetia enjoys every one of the 30 minutes it takes to design her own personal shoes. Venetia orders a pair of two color-toned brown and black pumps. She can't wait until they're done. Nojima-san makes shoes for Venetia at his workshop.
When assessing Venetia's feet, I found that her left foot was slightly thicker than her right foot, especially around her toes. The shape of each foot was also a bit different, so I have to shape her shoes accordingly and change a few things. I've made some adjustments in her shoes so it will fit her feet just right.
He adds leather to the wood to fit the measurements. He tries to recreate the customer's feet in his work, but the measurements aren't always based on the feet.
Part of my work is having the customers choose the designs they want. I don't just make the requested design. I really observe my customers. For example, how they come up and down the stairs, how they talk, sit, hold their shoes, put on their shoes, their sense of style, etc. Observing these things are really important to me for personalizing each shoe.
Nojima-san strives to make shoes that fit his customers perfectly. But he didn't always think he would do this for a living.
Let us pause in life's pleasures and count its many tears.
He grew up in Shizuoka Prefecture, where he started learning kendo from very early on in his childhood. He practiced kendo for 20 years, but he felt something was missing.
I didn't particularly excel at sports, nor was I necessarily the best athlete. But I could do a lot of things pretty well, quite easily. Maybe because of that, I never tried too hard at a lot of things. And when I quit kendo, I wanted to focus all that energy that I couldn't use practicing kendo on something else. And for me, that happened to be on making shoes. At first, it didn't go well, and I was very frustrated. But I chose this path, so I knew I needed to stick with it and give it my best.
Because he had problems at first, that forced him to work harder. Nojima-san had always been interested in fashion, so he first got a job at a shoemaker in Asakusa, Tokyo. He learned how to make shoes by himself and opened up his own shop 4 years ago. He had always been interested in Japanese culture.
"'Tis the song and the sign of the weary."
Instead of trying to copy European styles, Nojima-san felt it was important to focus on traditional Japanese footwear. This gave his work special meaning and ultimately became something that set him apart in his profession.
Kendo is a very traditional Japanese sport, and because I practiced kendo for so long, I guess it made me proud of my Japanese heritage and very aware of Japanese essence. That's why I felt like it would be best for me to focus on making shoes with a traditional Japanese style to them.
P People wear shoes every day. Nojima-san wants to make comfortable shoes for these people, combining Japanese and Western styles. He makes shoes to make people's walk down the path of life more comfortable.
One of the first things made by our ancestors all around the world was a pair of shoes to protect their feet and keep them warm. The earliest cobblers made sandals from rawhide or plaited grass. Shoes were carved out of wood or stitched in leather, fur, or felt. As a child, my feet were very narrow and my arches were low. So it was hard to find a size that would perfectly fit. So my mother ordered special remedial shoes from a cobbler. They were so comfortable, and they made my feet stronger. Still now, rather than buying shoes, I find that it's more practical to order shoes. For in the long run, they will last a lot longer. A skilled cobbler is always happy to repair the shoes if they need to be rehealed or resoled. He can also stretch them if they become too tight. Strong and healthy feet are good for walking. They carry us every day throughout our life.
There are many temples and shrines with a lot of history in Higashiyama, Kyoto. Venetia enjoys spending time with her husband, Tadashi, in autumn. Kiyomizu Temple is known all around the world as a World Heritage Site. As the sun goes down, the stage is set at Kiyomizu Temple. There is a piano concert held here once a year. This is the sixth year of this annual concert that brings Kyoto and Spanish culture together. The performer is Venetia's friend, who lives in Spain, Mine Kawakami.
今日は皆さんとスペインの巡礼の道を一緒にピアノの音を通して歩けたらなと思っています。
Venetia loves this song. She thinks of the beautiful landscape of Ohara when she hears it. Venetia says that if life were four seasons, she is living in autumn. Many great memories come to mind as she listens. And she wants to make more memories from here on out.
NHK World TV from Japan.